I am sitting here with Abby Allwood. She is an astrobiologist, and we are going to talk exploring Mars. So first of all, tell me what exactly an astrobiologist does.
Particular astrobiology I do is looking for signs of ancient microbial life.
So how do we look for ancient signs of life on Mars?
Well, the clues are in the rocks, or they're going to be in the rocks. So you have to go to a planet like Mars, or looking at the early rock record on Earth. We want to go and find places as recorded in the rock record, look for clues that there was a habitable environment in the past. For example, we need water for life to exist. So we look for clues in the chemistry or the structure of the rocks that say this was a wet environment. And then we take instruments that can look for chemical and organic and textural clues in the rocks that microbial life may have once lived there in the past.
You've got an instrument on the Mars 2020 rover. So why don't you tell me a little bit about what your instrument is and what exactly it's going to do?
So my instrument is PIXEL, which stands for Planetary Instrument for X-ray Lithochemistry. And that simply means that it uses X-rays to look at the chemistry of rocks. And how that relates to life is, so if there were microbes in the past, they can leave, in the past environments where rocks were being formed, they can leave chemical clues in the rocks that they once existed there, so we can detect those. But also more broadly, if you want to narrow the search down from just a lucky dip approach, is there life here, is there life there, you use the clues in the rock record to guide you to where the most habitable environments were, and also where the subsequent conditions that the rocks saw were going to preserve the fossils, or preserve the chemical clues.
So it's often said that Spirit and Opportunity are geologists, MSL is a chemist or geochemist. What is 2020?
2020 is all of the above. So 2020 needs to be a geologist to study the rocks in the landing site area, the area that we're going to collect samples from. And it's also going to be a chemist to analyse the chemistry of those rocks. So it's going to use all of the instruments on board to try and interpret the geological clues, the chemical clues of the area to try and understand if life could have existed there in the past, and also to see directly if there are any potential clues there.